Good morning, children. This is J.C. Benoy, your SST teacher. Hope you're all doing well and are staying safe. Take care of yourselves and wash your hands regularly. Now, today we are going to continue with our chapter 4 of SST called Realms of the Earth. What is the name of the lesson? Realms of the Earth. And we studied till about lithosphere yesterday. We saw how there are different realms of the earth, the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and how all these spheres together form the biosphere and are called the realms of the earth. Today we're going to start with hydrosphere. Lithosphere, you remember, was all about the land and the layers of the earth. And today, hydrosphere. Now, hydrosphere is the sphere of water. All the water bodies on the earth, including the lakes, the rivers, the snow, the glaciers on the mountain peaks, clouds in the air, all together form the hydrosphere. And it covers nearly 71% of the earth's surface. And so the earth is also known as the blue planet. Why is the earth known as the blue planet? It is known as the blue planet because it is covered by water in different forms by up to nearly 71% of the earth's surface. Now, water in all its forms is always moving. It is constantly moving. Water in the rivers and oceans moves into the atmosphere. How does the water go into the atmosphere? Through a process called evaporation. Now, what is evaporation? Evaporation is the process by which the water transforms into vapor. When water converts into vapor, water from where? From the oceans and from the rivers, evaporates and goes into the atmosphere. That is called evaporation. And what happens once the water evaporates? It then moves into it starts cooling down, and then the process of condensation takes place. Now, what is condensation? It is a process where the vapor transforms into water. The water vapor that is evaporated from the oceans and the seas becomes water vapor. And when the water vapor they form into clouds, rain clouds, and when they become cooler, all right, they come down in the form of rain or snow. That is called precipitation. When the water vapor comes down in the form of rain and snow, it is called as precipitation. So what is a precipitation? Precipitation is any form of water that falls on earth. Any form of water that falls on earth after the process of evaporation and condensation is called as the precipitation. Now, all this together, that is the evaporation, condensation, and precipitation, all together form the water cycle and form an important part of the hydrosphere. So this is what we have to look into, the hydrosphere. What is hydrosphere? Hydrosphere is any form of water body, including the clouds and the glaciers, is called the hydrosphere. They form the hydrosphere. Now, what happens to the water from these water bodies? They evaporate. What is the process of evaporation? The water becomes vapor, and then that vapor turns into clouds. That is the process of condensation. And when the water vapor comes down in the form of any form of water that can be snow or rain, it is called as precipitation. The whole thing together is called as the water cycle. Now, this is the topic of hydrosphere. Please remember what is hydrosphere and please learn the water cycle. Now, we are going to go to the next realm of the earth called the atmosphere. And this is how the atmosphere looks from the space. Can you see the different colors that are there? This is about the earth. And it forms like a blanket, like a protective layer around the earth. And atmosphere is a realm of the earth. And what is it basically? It is basically a mixture of gases, different gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, and many other gases. Now, it forms like a blanket around the earth. And what does this blanket do? It protects the earth from the harmful rays of the sun. All right. the harmful rays of the sun cannot come and destroy the earth because of this protective layer around the earth. The different colors that you can see, how it gradually fades into the space, is actually the different layers of the atmosphere. Now, what are these different layers of the atmosphere? They are troposphere. The layer which is immediately above the land of Earth is called the troposphere. Next is the stratosphere, followed by the mesosphere, ionosphere, and the exosphere. So, what are the layers of the atmosphere? They are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere, and exosphere. Today we are only going to learn the names of these spheres. We are not going to go into an in-depth study of these spheres of the atmosphere. You just have to remember that the atmosphere is a mixture of gases and it acts like a blanket around the earth and protects the earth from the harmful rays of the sun, and it filters it down so that we can live and exist on earth. Now, atmosphere supports life on earth, and we breathe the oxygen present in the atmosphere. And we also saw that there are different gases in the air, right, in the atmosphere. Now, we are going to see the composition of these gases. Nitrogen comprises of nearly 78% of the atmosphere. And how does nitrogen help us? Nitrogen helps to make our soil fertile. How? The nitrogen from the air is always in touch with the surface of the earth, and it continuously keeps mingling with the earth, with the soil on earth, and that is how it goes into the soil and makes it fertile. So it is one component of the atmosphere which makes the soil fertile. What about carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide, you know, helps the plants to breathe and prepare food. If there was no carbon dioxide, would the plants be able to prepare food? No. Would we be able to exist? No. So that is why carbon dioxide is also important. And what about oxygen? Without oxygen, would we be able to breathe? Would we be able to live? So oxygen is a very vital component of our survival. We need oxygen to breathe and to live. And there, apart from this, there are other gases also in smaller compositions, and they are all an important part of the atmosphere. So what all have we learnt about the atmosphere today? We have learnt that the atmosphere is a realm of air, and it is basically a mixture of different gases. It forms a protective layer around the earth and protects the earth from the harmful rays of the sun, and it helps life to grow on earth. Now, like the lithosphere, there are different layers of the atmosphere. What are the layers? They are the troposphere, the stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere, and exosphere. So these are the layers of the atmosphere. And that is how we are able to live on Earth. And it is composed of different gases, which include nitrogen. And how does nitrogen help us? It helps by making the soil fertile. And oxygen helps us to breathe. Nitrogen helps the soil become fertile, and carbon dioxide helps the plants to prepare food. And that is why it is important that we take care of our atmosphere, because when we pollute our air, we are harming ourselves. We are destroying the composition of the atmosphere, which has helped to keep up and protect life on earth for so many centuries. So that is why we need to take care of our atmosphere. Now, the next realm that we are going to study is the biosphere. What is the biosphere? We earlier saw that altogether, the lithosphere, the hydrosphere, and the atmosphere together form the biosphere. And what does the biosphere do? It is the part or the sphere where life exists on Earth. Life on Earth cannot exist anywhere else. It has to be in the biosphere. And where is this biosphere? In the land, in the air, in the water. And so biosphere is overlapping all these spheres of the Earth, and all together form the natural surroundings of our life. All the living and the non-living aspects of our world have an impact on our life, and that is why it is important that we take care of the plants, the animals, the trees, the plants, water, everything, all the water bodies around us, all we need, the mountains, we need to take care of all these aspects of the biosphere. Otherwise, it can have very harmful impact on our lives. Now, what are the adverse impact that that can happen in case but the biosphere is affected? Like, for example, let us take deforestation. What is deforestation? Deforestation is where we are cutting off trees, we are destroying the forests. And what happens when we destroy the forests? The animals living in the forests, they lose their homes, they lose their lives. What else happens because of deforestation? It takes away the food and the fodder supply of the people, of those who are dependent on these forests, on these trees. There are many other occupations which are based on these trees and forests. So when you take away those forests, you're taking away their source of livelihood. Another impact is on the natural impact of the climate. What happens? The lack of trees, what will happen because of the lack of trees? It is going to cause mud flows. Now, what are mud flows? It is this huge slide of mud which comes down and destroys everything. And it is happening all over the world. We can see this happening all over the world. This is because of the soil erosion that starts taking place because of lack of trees holding on to the soil. So that is one major adverse effect. What is the other adverse or bad effect of the deforestation? Another effect is the floods. We are seeing more and more floods in our country, all across the world. Why is this happening? It is also happening because of the deforestation that is taking place all over the world. So it is our job to protect our environment. It is our job to protect the biosphere, which includes the forests, the trees, the mountains, the land, the water, the air that we breathe. And all this together, if we start taking care, only then we will be able to protect our lives and the lives of everybody else on Earth. So that is why it is important for us to understand that the biosphere is important, and that all the realms of the Earth, the atmosphere, the hydrosphere, the lithosphere, all these spheres together are important for our survival, for the survival of life on Earth. We're going to stop here. Please go through the video again. This is an end of the chapter 4 of SST. The lesson's name is Realms of the Earth. Please understand what the different realms of the Earth were and what do they comprise of, and how we can protect our, why do we need to protect the biosphere. I'm going to stop here. Have a nice day. Thank you.